sense of determination from Rajinder Simina. Four times in one championship. Yet to experience a win, but he's taken on the best of the best, including Shannon Mirichai, Amir Khan, Honorio Benario. Can he finally get that win on the board? Let's see how the yoga and the meditation over the last 4 weeks pays off for Rajinder Simina.
Typically, we see Rajinder Simina only moving back and forth. I'd like to see him utilize some lateral movement, moving left and moving right, can always move in his head.
Two very large, well-built lightweights. And Rajinder Simina gets a knockdown. The ground and pound, he'll try and sink a choke. A house on fire, the Indian. Can he find the finish here? This would be a huge upset. Zhang Zhihao stuck in his attempted guillotine at the moment. Rajinder Simina has rendered Zhang Zhihao momentarily out of it to take the victory in the sweetest of fashions. My word, Mitch. Certainly the yoga and meditation paid off.
That's all he needed was to get his mind right. He has all the skills to reach the very top, and he did it tonight. What a tremendous punch landed. As Zhang Zhihao was coming in, he caught him. Decided not to go for the ground and pound, saw the guillotine open, jumped on the choke.
Let's go to Dominic Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kemp Chang, has put a stop to this contest after 42 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of guillotine, Rajinder Simina.
He still can't believe it. And I'm sure many people watching around the world can't either. Zhang Zhihao, his first ever loss. Rajinder Simina, in epic fashion, gets his first ever one championship win. First round guillotine. You could not have predicted that. In front of a sellout crowd inside Istora Senayan in Jakarta, Indonesia. And Lumban Goal continue her winning way. She's in southpaw stance here in the pink, black and grey. Puja Tomar of India in the white trunks. Jab two, high right roundhouse. Put nothing but air there for Tomar. Good two-punch combination from the Indian. Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal, her name is long. It reads like an eye chart, but her fights can be very short. She can finish them quickly.
Watch Priscilla try to lure Puja Tomar into a false sense of security by striking with her. And then she's gonna slide in for that double leg, maybe attack that single leg because it's right there.
Both women know each other extremely well. Puja Tomar said she studied hours of video on Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal and found some chinks in the armor of the Indonesian. Can she expose Priscilla tonight? If Priscilla gets the win, particularly by knockout or submission, they will have an absolute meltdown inside this sold-out arena. Good release of the right hand there from Priscilla.
Look at Priscilla, very happy to engage. Very comfortable stance in that southpaw position. She utilized that push kick very well. Nice little counter there from Tomar.
Tomar had the right idea. She's switching between orthodox and southpaw too. Looking for a wushu sidekick there was Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. If you've seen wushu competition before, you know that the cutting sidekick to the midsection or to the top of the thigh is one of the prime weapons in the wushu arsenal. High right roundhouse kick there from Tomar. As I said, in every match tonight, we featured champions from all different martial arts. Here we have two wushu champions in the cage. And Tomar trying to let fly with her hands.
Tomar is touching up the face of Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. You can see the damage starting to build up. Priscilla's marching forward now, keeping staying nice and light on her feet. Tomar's a little bit more flat-footed.
A 15-5 record in wushu for Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. Tomar, a four-time national wushu champion between 2014 and 2017, competing at 48 kilograms. There's that side kick again from Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. Little flat-footed here, Priscilla. More on the balls of her feet is Puja Tomar. And there's a side kick from the Indian. Switches to orthodox stance. That's her preferred stance.
It's interesting how they're changing it up, because I just said the exact opposite of what you just said. But Tomar, she is mixing things up, though. She is changing between the stance, and that seems to be effective for her. She said that was her game plan coming in, was to try to confuse Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal, to not give her the same look, and she's doing that. She's also piecing her up a little bit.
Priscilla's got to watch the left hand of Tomar. Already there is quite a bit of swelling above the right eye of Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. Take down there, and Tomar finds herself in top position. Look at her pass the guard of the Indonesia.
Look at Tomar getting the takedown there off that hit headlock throw. Changing the game a little bit on Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. Now she's in the top position. Priscilla's just holding on to the head there, hoping for possibly a stand-up. Maybe want to get those butterfly hooks in and elevate the hips, because you can see how forward Tomar is. She's really coming in forward, a little bit of balance. She's got to sit back into her hips and stay nice and balanced.
Puja Tomar has never won by submission. Priscilla has 2 out of 5 wins by submission. Ground and pound attempt, looks to pass to side control now Tomar, and gets there the Indian. Have a look at this from Puja Tomar. She's going to try and mount Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. She takes the back. It's crazy here from Tomar. She's got her back. Oh my! Oh my! She's got the hooks in. And can she flatten her out? Yes, she can.
Wow, that's a shocker. Look at Tomar getting control of the back now to end the round. She's got about 18 seconds here. Let's see if she can stick in that rear naked choke. She might just want to throw some bombs now.
Puja Tomar flattens her out like an Indonesian pancake. My word, Puja Tomar in control. Nobody expected this. Nobody expected this. Incredible scenes here in Jakarta.
Wow, Puja Tomar came here to spoil the Indonesian party, getting the back of Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal and then dropping some bombs to end that round. Look at that, countered the push kick to throw that big right hand. Look at her throwing it again, landing with the overhand right, catches the side kick, unorthodox catch on that side kick too, to throw the overhand right to piece it up. Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. Very impressive so far from Puja Tomar, Michael Cervello.
That was the best round we have seen yet in Puja Tomar's career. And look at the face of Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. The welts, the scratches, the swelling. It tells a story. It's a story of late round dominance from Puja Tomar. And at the moment, you could hear tumbleweeds blowing through this enormous arena, because they are as shocked as we are at what Puja Tomar did in the final 40 seconds of that opening round. Referee Olivia Coles to get us underway. What a show to kick off one championship in 2019. Southpaw stance on Priscilla. Hands up very high.
Tomar's got some heat behind that right hand. Look at her. She's countering off the kicks. When Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal throws that right side kick, Tomar's countering it well.
Probing with the lead hand is the Indian, Puja Tomar.
Yep, looking for that right hand.
Now the crowd rallies behind Priscilla. Can she get Tomar down?
Good balance so far from Tomar. She's got that guillotine right there. Priscilla's got to keep her head up.
Knees to the top of the thigh from Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal.
Tomar going for a headlock throw again. You can see she was attempting that headlock to throw the side kick. Oh, with a beautiful high kick on the right side there.
Priscilla coming forward very warily now. She's tasted the power of Tomar in the first round. And Tomar switching stance between southpaw and orthodox. Looks for the counter right hand off of Priscilla's kick.
That's what Tomar's trying to do. She's timing that kick. It doesn't matter where Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal is throwing that kick from. Tomar's timing it brilliantly.
3 minutes 25 remains. Second round of three. First round, a great finish by Puja Tomar. The ground and pound was spectacular. And she also took the back, tried to choke out Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. Punt kick there from Tomar. Two Wushu champions in the cage. Tomar is trying to put herself on the map in this very heated atomweight division. A win here for Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal could see her maybe only one match away from a possible world title tilt.
The atomweight division is really interesting right now, Michael, especially with the champ, Angela Lee, going up the challenge for the strawweight belt. You know, it's a very interesting situation right now for the atomweights.
Angela will take on Zhong Jinnan for the strawweight world title in Japan, Tokyo, March 31st. Sidekick there from Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. Tomar very patient. She won't overextend herself. She'll wait for an opening. Fires that roundhouse kick off the lead leg, then puts it the back as she goes to orthodox stance. Tried to drop down for a single leg. Gets stuck in this choke attempt here. What's going on with the guillotine here, Mitch?
She's got an arm in guillotine. You can see the arm there of Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. So it's a bit difficult to do it, especially from the standing position. But she chooses to let it go. Now Priscilla's got her pressed up against the cage. You gotta see Puja Tomar get some underhooks. Right now she's got 50-50 position. One under, one over. Good job by Puja Tomar to defend that.
Priscilla edges forward again. She's in the pink and gray. Puja Tomar in the white. Wild uppercut. Almost took out the ring lights.
You can see that Puja Tomar is countering off the one shot thrown by Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. Priscilla's throwing one punch, one kick, and then Tomar's coming back with a flurry. And that's how she's being successful.
You're seeing those Wushu sidekicks employed again by both these martial artists. Priscilla faking there. Fakes the jab out of southpaw stance. Now they clinch up.
Press so far with Priscilla's defense from the clinch. You know, she's going for the 50-50 positions. She's making sure she has the body lock. She's going to showcase some good balance. Just as I say that, she gets dumped on her butt. There's a possible triangle here from Puja Tomar on the bottom.
Listen to this crowd go crazy for Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. The knee on belly for Priscilla. Look at Priscilla tie her up in a demented game of Twister. She's going to hunt after a submission. They're both playing a submission game, Dragon.
Not much there. Possible knee bar. Oh, wait. Is she going to go out of it? That was close.
Oh, Tomar looks like she's in pain.
Oh, Tomar thought about the tab.
Tomar's grimacing.
Oh, didn't quite have it.
Oh, pops her in the jaw. Just letting her know she's still there. Crazy scene to end the round. Just as Tomar entered the first round strongly, Hertati Lumban Goal finishes the second round strongly.
Tomar's still on her back. A little bit of exhaustion. Let's see some of the action from the past. Look at this, Tomar coming in and just goes up top with a beautiful right roundhouse to the chin of Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. Now that round was a little bit closer. Let's take a look at this attempt here at a knee bar. I think that's a little bit too far into the submission sequence, but you can see Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal was cranking the knee in an unorthodox position, and Tomar thought about the tap, but she managed to shrug it off and stay in it. Two rounds down so far of a very interesting atomweight showdown.
It has all come down to this. The third and final round inside the sold-out Istora Senayan in Jakarta, Indonesia. It's one championship, eternal glory. This atomweight showdown between Puja Tomar of India and Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal of Indonesia. Champion versus champion. Two Wushu champions are showing off their striking prowess.
It's a pretty close match right now, Michael Sabello. This is definitely the pinnacle of Puja Tomar's competitive career. She is putting on a very good performance. Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal has got to shift gears on this and level up.
Puja Tomar has come out here tonight to show the watching world that she is not cannon fodder. Just missed with a counter. Here we go. Boom! Shakalaka! And the crowd loves it in Jakarta.
Puja Tomar's got an arm in guillotine. Crank it on the neck. Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal is going to pick her back up.
Pops the head out, does Priscilla. They are raising the roof in Jakarta for Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal.
Oh, look at Priscilla dropping down to attack the leg. Looks like she's going for a Boston crab here, Michael.
Trying to employ her inner Rick Martel. Top position for Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. Close guard from Tomar. Can she posture up here, Priscilla? And the chance go up again. Listen to this. Absolutely crazy scenes of pandemonium inside the Istora Senayan in Jakarta.
Puja Tomar has still got the guard. She's got to try to attack. She's just trying to keep the head nice and close, while possibly hoping for a stand-up. But you can see that Priscilla's being just active enough to delay that possible stand-up. She has to pat in the head, a little bit of activity. Tomar's got to push away and stand back up.
Priscilla hasn't won by submission since February last year. A scarf hold arm lock. I should say against Rome Trinidad. That was in May of last year. She guillotine choked Rome. Before that was a scarf hold arm lock against Crystal Embarga. Looking for a downward elbow there in the ground and pound. And Puja closes the guard, tries to keep it tight. She doesn't want those hands, those elbows raining down on her face.
Tomar's not being very active in her guard. She's at least got to start creating a little bit of space so she can throw some elbows to do a little bit of damage on this. You can see, just because you're on top does not necessarily mean you're winning, especially in our scoring. So she's got to be a little bit more active from the bottom. She's got to create space. She's got to attack. She's got to try to advance her position. You can see Priscilla's just touching her up. She's not really doing anything. She's not really creating any damage on this.
1 minute 40 remained. Third and final round. Priscilla trying to break open that guard of the Indian. Crazy scenes. Glow sticks are waving. Everybody's chanting. They're out of their seats inside the sold-out Istora Senayan.
Puja's got to be a little bit more active here. She's got to create some separation. Right now, she's just holding on to the head. I think she believes she's too far ahead so far, so she's not trying to create any movement. I'd like to see her open her guard, get her butterfly hooks in, because you can see how much forward pressure, how far she's leaning over, but she's sweeping her. Oh, gives up her back in the process, Michael.
Oh, Priscilla has the back. Is this the beginning of the end?
Oh, this would be magnificent if
they're gonna go nuts if she taps her. They're gonna go crazy if she taps her.
Tomar's tough. She's hanging in there. That's close.
Referee Olivia Coast right on top of the action. Priscilla wants to choke her out. Wants to put her to sleep.
Tomar's got to pull the hands off her head. She's got to peel those hands off.
25 seconds on the clock. She's going to soften her up a little more now.
Punch her way home. 18 seconds.
Tomar's still in it. Unrelenting with the left hand. And Tomar tries to defend against those punches. Final 10 seconds. Can she choke her? It's more of a face crank.
Look at Tomar. She's got a spin. She can spin and end up on top. Oh,
what a match. The performance of Tomar's career. Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal brought home the round strongly, as she did in the second. This was one for the ages. Wherever you're watching in 138 countries, how did you score it? For Puja Tomar or for Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal? The Indian or the Indonesian? Okay, let's go to Tom Lau, find out our winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this contest in favor of the red corner. Judge number two scores this contest in favor of the blue corner. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision from the blue corner, Puja Tomar.
Puja Tomar pulls off a major upset. She spoils the Indonesian party. Someone forgot to show Puja Tomar the script. Nobody expected that. She is emotional.
The first match of our prelim show, two martial arts champions in the cage. Iggy Rosten of Indonesia, boxing champion. Himanshu Kaushik of India, karate and wushu champion. It's Kaushik left of screen in the black trunks. You will see those cunning side kicks, the wushu stylings from Himanshu Kaushik. And let's see if Rosten pulls the pin on the hand grenades in his hands early on here.
Roundhouse kick came real close to connecting on Rosden. Now, you spoke about the revenge factor that Puja Tomar just came away with a big win out there in Indonesia over Priscilla Hertati Lumban Goal. Puja Tomar and Himanshu Kaushik actually trained at the same wushu school in India, so there's definitely a lot of confidence going into this match and knowing that his wushu style is effective against these Indonesian athletes.
This would be unheard of if Kaushik gets a win tonight, to have back-to-back wins for India in one championship. It's never been done before. Can Himanshu Kaushik be the man to do it? Outside leg kick there from Kaushik.
Like how he went low, he went after that calf, and that's a sensitive area. You're not used to getting, you know, kicked at that spot. You, when you train leg kicks in practice, you train getting kicked in the thighs, not in those calves.
As a boxer, Rosden has to get on the inside of those kicks. He wants to go the body, then up to the jaw with those powerful hands of his. Tries to bridge the gap there, Rosden, and Kaushik a little too slick for him. Goes to the outside thigh again. Now, one way to slow down a boxer is to kick his legs.
That's what Kaushik's doing very effectively right now. He landed about four. Looks like he went low there.
And one strike, clean one there. Accidental, of course. Kaushik was going for the upper inside thigh and just connected a little south of the border there on Iggy Rosden. You see the instep connected to the groin of Rosden, and he felt it straight away, did Iggy.
That was the strategy of Himanshu Kaushik. Now he's got 5 minutes of injury time for medical examination recovery. If the athlete is unable to resume in the allotted time, an official decision will be given. But this decision is only given at the halfway point. Looks like Rosden is okay. But Rosden's got to figure out an answer to these kicks, because that was Himanshu Kaushik's game plan going into this match, is he wanted to keep Rosden at kicking range.
What Rosden's going to try and do here is look to counter off these low kicks of Kaushik. Try and get his timing when Kaushik lands to the leg, immediately spring with a counter straight rider, a counter left hook. Tries for the old 3-2 combination there as the regional boxing champion from Indonesia. There it is. There's the counter off the low kick. And it was the straight right hand indeed. Catches the leg there. There's Kaushik. Down goes Rosden on his back. Not preferably where he wants to be.
Kaushik's got to settle down. As soon as Rosden. Rosden tried to pop right back up immediately, but he didn't quite have the positioning. Now Kaushik's going to try to get heavy into half guard. Looks like Rosden's going to get back into full guard.
Closes the guard here. There's Eggy Rosden off of his back. Himanshu, Kaushik, Wushu, and Karate Champion on top. So he went to the body there off the left hand by Kaushik. Looking to pop the head out, trying to break open that guard, posture up and work some ground and pound against the wire here.
You can see Kaushik's trying to press him up against the cage, deliver a little bit of ground and pound. Rosden's keeping him nice and tight, but now he's let go. So now Kaushik's going to be able to posture up and start throwing down the punches. Let's see if he can step over and try to pass the half guard. You can see the right leg of Rosden's not really doing a whole lot. He can just push down on it with his left hand. He couldn't step over.
Rosden does have an 80% finishing rate. The Indonesian looking for mixed martial arts win number 6 here. He's 5-1 coming in tonight. 4 knockouts, 4 decision. Yet to 7 opponent. Kaushik comes in 4-3. 1 knockout, 3 decisions. Also yet to win by submission. Big right hand there from Kaushik. Is it going to be back-to-back wins for India? Yes, it is! That's history made here in Manila. Himanshu Kaushik pounds out Eggy Rosden. That's the revenge. No, it's a repeat in Manila. Back-to-back wins, Puja Tomar in Jakarta, Himanshu Kaushik in Manila.
We spoke about the confidence going in there. The win from Puja Tomar put Kaushik in a great place. Look at this. Once he got the space, he was able just to let the fists come flying down. It was about the third or the fourth one that did the damage. And he just captured a huge win over a surging contender. Eggy Rosden came in off of 2 back-to-back wins, and now Himanshu Kaushik just put an exclamation point.
The terrible start to the year for Indonesia continues. The brilliance from India continues. Let's go to Dom Lau and make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Yuji Shimada, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 33 seconds in the first round for your winner, by way of knockout, Himanshu Kaushik.
That is massive. Indian martial arts is no longer flying under the radar here at ONE Championship. The national wushu and karate champion of India will take the medal home.